ancient king and elvish lord. There many a gleaming golden horn.
Hello and welcome to the latest episode of Line on Book, my progression style playthrough series of the Lord of the Rings Limited card game. I'm playing Nightmare Version of the Lonely Mountain, which, of course, is the second quest from the second Hobbit Saga box. So, the Nightmare card here tells me, while there is at least one card stacked underneath the Lonely Mountain, the player's count advances stage 3, and Smaug the Magnificent cannot take damage unless a bear patch is attached to him. Neither of these really make a difference to me. So, the regular setup, Surge the Incarnate for Smaug the Golden, Smaug the Magnificent, blah blah blah. Smaug the Magnificent and a bear patch are set aside out of play. Smaug the Golden and the Lonely Mountain are in the staging area. I suppose I don't need to open this up because I can just control shift to bring cards out of it. Shuffle the 5 variable treasure cards and stack them face down into the Lonely Mountain. I will track the threat of the Lonely Mountain on here, because of course it has -2 threat for each card stacked under it. Since currently there are 5 cards stacked under it, it has 2 threat rather than 12. So one day, although autumn is now getting far on, and winds were cold and leaves were falling fast, 3 large boats left Lake Town, laden with rowers, dwarves, Mr. Baggins, and many provisions. Skip the quest phase, at the end of the Rebel Battle Station 2. So, just a free round. Which is great. Okay. So, I'm going to play We Are Not Idle. Exhausting Glenn to add a resource to him and draw a card. Then I can pay 2 for King Under the Mountain. And exhaust it to look at these 2 cards. I'll take the Citadel plate. And let's play Arwen. Over here. Oh, hang on. Put those resources back because I should play Deep Knowledge first. Also play this down in dreams. Okay. And I will discard one of the island's councils. And okay, so I'll play the beats from Erebor on to Glen. Still play Arwen. Over here, let's play Vilya. No, actually, let's also use Bearable on this deck. Okay. And then, yes, I play Vilya. Exhaust Arwen in Vilya. Dwarf in the Tomb. Let's see. Can immediately play a button to play the revealed card for no cost. There you go, I'll just remove it to the bottom of your deck. I mean, I could pull the Arwen's Council back into my hand, but I think actually I would rather just send the Dwarven Tomb to the bottom of my deck. And so that'll be it for the round. Skip quest phase. Nothing else happens. Billboard moves over here. Control M. And we advance to stage 2. There he lay, a vast red golden dragon, fast asleep. Thrumming came from his jaws and nostrils and wisps of smoke, but his fires were low in slumber. Beneath him, under all his limbs and his huge coiled tail, and about him on all sides, stretching away across the unseen floors, lay countless piles of precious things, gold-wrought and unwrought, gems and jewels, and silver red-stained in the ruddy light. After questing successfully, place one progress on Smiles of the Gold, and then the first player makes a burglar attempt. If successful, the first player takes the top treasure card from under the lonely mountain into his hand. Then the players may advance to stage 3. Of course, that is not actually the case, because this says that we can't advance to stage 3 while there are still cards under the lonely mountain. So I have to get all of the treasures. I can't just get some of them and then stop, as I could in the non-nightmare version of the quest. This isn't really a problem, because I've never played this quest and not tried to get all the treasures. After the first player makes an unsuccessful burglar attempt, Smaug the Golden attacks the first player. So, okay, we are going to move around, I'll draw an extra card. Okay. So let's see, I think the only thing I really want to play here is Asphalt and Gryffindor. Over here, let's use King Under the Mountain. Okay, there we go, Light of Valinor is the thing that I want. And that will probably have to be it. I can't afford anything else. So I should save up my resources. Okay, now of course, Smaug the Golden is X threat. X is the number of non-burglar characters committed to the quest. So, let's quest 1, 3, 6, 10, 12, and see how that goes. So Smaug is 4 threat, the Lonely Mountain is 2, that's a total of 6. Should be okay. And we reveal terrible bats. Okay. And Southern Spur. In the panel play we played, he played at least one ally this phase, and his base is threat by 1. Okay. Well, that's added 6 threat to the staging area. So currently, we are questing unsuccessfully. Well, no, we're not. We are breaking even. We are not questing successfully, which would mean I would not get to make a burglar attempt. So, I think I may want to correct that, so let's play this copy of L1's Council. Reduce my threat by 3 and increase willpower by 1. So I quest successfully, place a progress token on Smaug the Golden, which means the first player makes a burglar attempt, so I discard cards until I find a burglar effect. First player shuffles his deck and reveals the top card. He may discard 3 cards from his hand that match the reveal's card's type. Top card is an attachment. Well, that's really not helpful. I have no attachments in my hand. So let's use the action on the Lonely Mountain. Pay two Baggins resources to take the revealed card into my hand and reveal the next card of my deck, which is Dory, an ally. So if I can discard three allies from my hand, I will pass the test. Let's exhaust Barrowhall to draw two cards. Okay, and then let's discard three allies. One, two, three. I pass the Burgle test and take the top treasure, Flaw's Hunting Bow. I should have mentioned Arwen targets Frodo until I say otherwise. So, we would like to keep the threat out of the staging area and also get rid of this location. I was asked for that to put two progress on it and travel there. Now I have to engage these bats. Let's exhaust Elrond in the video to... Okay, deep knowledge. And then let's play this deep knowledge as well. And okay, I'm going to leave it at that. So there are the bats. I will engage them with this deck. Do a shadow card. And yeah, I'm going to take this attack on defense. So when the Arrow Bats attack, the Pendant player discards one random card from his hand. So random discard. I lost a Citadel plate. That's unfortunate. There's okay. No shadow effect. I put the damage on Glowing. Three damage, and he gains three resources. Glorfindel will attack, deal one damage. And that's it for the round. Control M. Bilbo over here. Extra draw for this deck. And now, of course, I have to remember the Southern Spur. Each player who plays an ally this phase will have to raise their threat by one. Now, let's see. I would like to have enough attack power to kill these bats, if possible. I would also like to get a Citadel plate into Glowing. So, yeah, I can do that. Well, I can use a good harvest to play the Citadel plate. I can also play Narvi's Belt. So yeah, maybe I'll just go with that. Good harvest tactics. 1, 2, 3, 4. Got a Citadel plate. And an extra two will get me Narvi's Belt. So there will be less need for Citadel Plate for a good harvest in future. Okay. And over here, I want some healing in play. This will require me to raise my threat. And I'm going to play Thrall's Hunting Bow. But I'm not entirely sure where. But I also have this unexpected courage. So, well, I could go for Bereval being able to attack and draw cards, or Elrond being able to Vilya and draw cards, or Vilya and quest. Oh no, sorry, Vilya and attack. They have the same attack value. Right now I need 7 to kill this. So, okay, yeah, I'm going to give the bow to Elrond. And the unexpected courage. Now, the Lonely Mountain is now 4 threat. And again, in the planning phase, this stuff has to raise its threat by 1. So, obviously, Bilbo's questing, so that's 1, 5, 8, 10. Yeah, 13. I can consider them, but let's see, if I make it 13, then 1, 2, 3, 4, so 13 against 8. I could go up to 15 against 9, or well, 17 against 10. To be making some progress, so ...17 against 10. And we reveal Bereval bats again and weighed down until the end of the round. Exhausted characters get -1 for power, attack, and defense. That is a problem. And I don't have a test of will for it. Oh no, I do have a test of will for it. I will play a test of will. So, I've added 3 threat to the staging area. I make 4 progress. And explore the Southern Spur. I quested successfully, so progress here, and I make a burgle test. The first player shuffles his deck and reveals the top card. He may discard one card from his hand that matches the revealed card's sphere and cost. Okay. 3 cost event. Oh no, sorry, 3 cost spirit. Okay. Well, I'm going to exhaust Bereval to let this deck draw 2 cards. And also the King Under the Mountain to repeat the top 2 and discard 1. Now, 3 cost spirit. I do have another Library of the Mark in hand over here. So, certainly get rid of one of these. Cost spirit, that's a match. And Black Thrall's Golden Cup. Now I have to deal with the second Bereval bats. And honestly, it's probably best to still have them here. haven't fully thought this through in retrospect, but okay. So when they attack, then discard. Test of course. Unfunded. Three damage to Gwarfen Bell. Heal with Elrond. And unfunded. Oh, and another one discard. We'll go to Gandalf. Yeah, Glowin has plenty of hit points. So there we go. Now, attacking for 3-7 is... let's do one with no damage yet, since it's 7 for either of them. Bilbo moves over here. This is up to 6 threat. Control in new round. Stargazer. Excellent. So let's play that Stargazer and leave it at that. And over here, King of the Mountain. Ditch. A good harvest, I shouldn't need it anymore. I still have less cards than I would. So let's give them Thor's Golden Cap. Now, how many resources do I have? 8. So let's just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for Gandalf. Let's go to that. And I will just use the card right now to have this deck draw 3 more cards. 2, 3. Okay. So, question 4, 8, 11, 13. 14. 17 versus 5 has cards under it. There's 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, one burger characters. Okay. Yeah, we'll go with this. And we reveal. Dragon's Ire, Doomed One. Each dragon enemy in play makes an immediate attack against each player in turn order. Do not deal shadow cards for the attacks. For each character that's destroyed by one of these attacks, place one progress on each dragon enemy in play. Okay, so that's 2 attacks for 6. But with no shadow cards. So Frodo defends for 3 and takes 3 threat. And how many hit points does Gwen have? Nine. So currently five remaining. If I heal him first, he could take the hit. But I also need to be able to defend this later. And what's his range? Okay. Yeah, let's generate a load of resources. Two, three, four, five, six. Six. And the second penalty staging is the Great Hall. While it's the active location, it gains force to put one progress on some development being granted. So I will not be traveling there. Since I have asked for long. So that's added four threats to the staging area. I quest successfully. And let's make a burgle test. Burgle. First player shuffles his deck and reveals the top card. He may discard two cards from his hand, but eventually reveal the card's type. So, shuffle. Ally. Two allies from my hand. Okay. So, well, let's play Daron's Runes. Draw two. Discard this superfluous Vilia. And now I'm going to use the Stargazer to look at the top five cards of my deck. Okay, so I'd quite like to get all of these into my hand apart from the extra barrier. So, sure. Daron's Runes. So I'll draw the test before I discard the extra Vilia. Oh, yeah, sorry. Let me check those three cards. No, I was going to be using all that for attacking, wasn't I? Yeah, so yeah, I think I can still do this. Go like this. Baron, draw two cards. And now I have to discard two allies from my hand. So one ally. And I important. Two allies. The burgle test is passed. So battle axe is on to my hand. The only mountain is up to eight threat. Now the combat phase. When the air robots attack, discard. Greeting, okay. And I'm just going to defend the Gandalf. Okay. Nothing happens. And I can kill the bats. To raise my threat by an extra two for Gandalf at the end of the round because I want to keep him in play. Control M. And let's put those back over here. This deck really needs to start lowering its threat. Oh no, sorry. In the refresh phase, I want to Vilia this rider of the mark into play, so card I draw is in fact this greeting. Okay. So, very still. Two treasures of the Lonely Mountain, so it doesn't need to have eight, correct? Let's also play the Library of the Mark over here. Play Faramir. And I can think about the Northern Tracker, but I don't think it's super important to do right away. Play Glaerwine. And leave it at that. So, questing. One. Five, eight, 12, 14, 16, 18, 18 versus 6. Okay, so that's 18 versus 18. This actually should be okay, because I have Elrond's Councils and Faramir, and I can explore the Great Hall with Ascalon. So let's see. Moon to announce. Each player discards two random cards from hand until the end of phase. Each dragon in the play gets a possible threat for each event discarded by this effect. Okay, and then discard. And then discard. Yes. And then discard. That's one event. And that's two events. So two extra threat. And Croaking Crows, which surge into doing one. Each player raises his threat by one for each attachment attached to a character he controls. Okay. Well, I really should have played my threat reduction in advance. Oh, hang on, I do have Test of Will. I should have cancelled the. Yeah, no. If I'd remembered I had a Test of Will, I would have cancelled the discarding thing. Because I want to hold on to my threat reduction events, which means there's two less threats on stage in the area. And I would have spent the resource from Frodo, not Elrond. Now, three attachments here, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 attachments here. Okay, this is okay. So there's another 19 threat in the staging area, and I'm going to just play these Elrond's Councils now to get my threat down. And this one. And while I'm at it, Exhaust Navi's Belt, Spirit. Pay three. Actually, no, I should hold off on that for a bit. We're okay for the moment, at least. And I will asphalt off the Great Hall. So now I've got to progress on Smell Golden and make a burgle test. So. Burgle, first player shuffles his deck and reveals the top card. He may discard one card from his hand that matches the revealed card's sphere and type. So, Spirit Event. Okay. From Glarewine, Barrowmore, and King Under the Mountain, I can get a lot more cards in my hand. Oh, no, this is the wrong deck. Spirit Ally. Well, this is still fine. So, Glarewine, Barrowmore, and King of the Mountain. Let's do King of the Mountain first. And then Glarewine and Barrowmore. So I have to discard a Spirit Ally. So that's a successful burgle test. I add the Arkenstone to my hand. This is up to 10 threat. Engage these crows. I'm going to use the Stargazer here. Yeah, I think that's okay. Actually, no, let's put it like that. That should be fine. And let's defend with Gandalf. Shadow effect. Glorfindel kills the crows. I can heal up Glowing. Right, and that will be it for the round. Extra 2 threat to keep Gandalf in play. Bilbo is over here. Control A. And now I use our Villiers for this greeting. Drop the threat to 38. Oh, actually, I could have used Navi's Belt. Yeah, last round, Navi's Belt, Spirit. Greeting to drop this deck by 6 as well. So now, I think I'm basically okay with what I've got here. So nothing for this deck over here. Yeah, let's actually yeah, let's play We Are Not Idle. Draw a card. And okay, that'll be it. So, questing 4, 8, 10, 13, 15, 16, 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 18 versus 16. This should be fine. reveal secret tunnel. Okay, that's no problem. And dragon spell. This is annoying. Attached to the hero with the most resources without dragon spell attached. Most of the time I've been deliberately making sure that Glowin has the most resources, because dragon spell and Glowin actually works out really well. But right now Bilbo has the most resources. So, in fact, I will just cancel this. Okay, I've added two threat, so I only need one extra willpower to quest successfully. I can get a lot more than that with Faramir. So, it doesn't matter which deck I target, because all I need to do is quest successfully. It doesn't matter by how much. So, Burgle test. First player shuffles his deck and reveals the top card. He can discard two cards from his hand to match the revealed card's cost and type. And okay, two cost ally. Doesn't look hopeful. Let's spend a couple of Bilbo's resources. Still two cost ally. I mean, I'd rather hold on to my Wardens of Healing, so I'm going to just do that again. Three cost ally. And it discards two of them? Yep, okay. So that's a ghost guy one. Drop card. And then let's use the Stargazer. Okay, yeah, two cost ally could have been done, like trying to get the guy ones, but never mind. I want to have some Demillion next round. It could be the unexpected courage. The drawing one also wouldn't hurt. Actually, no, keeping these to be Villiard is a reasonable idea, so let's just stick it like that and draw some superfluous cards into my head. And now I have to discard two 3-cost allies, which I can do. So that's a successful Burgle test. I'm going to throw a shirt. The Lonely Mountain is now its printing's 12 threat, and it is no longer immune to player card effects. And now I can advance to stage 3. They debated long on what was to be done. They could think of no way of getting rid of Smaug, which had always been a weak point in their plans, as Bilbo felt inclined to point out. Set Smaug had gone aside out of play, adds Smaug magnificent and the bear patch to the staging area. I'm just going to put a bear patch here to the other side. Players can't defeat this stage while Smaug and magnificent in play. Forced. If the total number of progress on this stage is greater than the total remaining hit points on Smaug the Magnificent, remove Smaug the Magnificent from play. If the players defeat the stage, they've won the game and discovered any treasure successfully burgled from the Lonely Mountain. So, of course, here we see the other point on the Nightmare card theoretically come into play. Smaug the Magnificent cannot take damage unless a bear patch is attached to him. But the same issue applies as applied to the non-nightmare version of this, that you can put more progress on a quest stage than it has quest points. So I don't actually have to reduce, deal any damage to Smoke Magnificent to get him out of play. I just need to make more than 20 progress on the quest. So I can just focus on questing really hard rather than trying to actually fight the dragon. So, okay. Obviously, I lock the Lonely Mountain out of the staging area. I can't travel the secret tunnel, so I should travel through the Lonely Mountain and use Asphaloth on the tunnel. So I have the Magnificent. Currently the staging area except by quest effect, but is considered to be engaged with the first player. So, I'm gonna use Cave of the Legend. Let's just do that now. I'm just going to keep the Alliance Council. Right, so do the Shadow Card. Spend a spirit resource to give control of Ragged Mark to this player and discard Shadow Card. That will then be arranged. It did have a burgle effect, so it's good that I did that. And now I'll pass this Ragged Mark over here. So I defend with Frodo and raise my threat by 6. Heal up Glorm. And that should be it for the round. Draw him. That's 2 points of threat for Gandalf here. Bring those back over on this side of the table. So, okay. Willpower is definitely a good idea. I need to save resources for moving my riders at the mark around. So, okay, I will play Dragon Stone on Glorfindel. And that'll be it. Over here. Let's take a look at the top 5 cards. Courage and Burrow. Let's play the Mithril Shirt onto Bilbo. And Thor's Battle Axe can go on Glorfindel. Don't care about the Arkenstein. Let's just put my healing on the table. Okay, maybe not all of it. Okay. I'm going to get a quest for these. I'm going to Dwarven Tomb in Elrond's Council. Then just play it. So that's one more. Two, six, 10, 15. Alright, step 15, 17, 19, 22, 24, 26, 28. This is 8 threat. Well, this is clearly not enough yet, but I do have Faramir in reserve. I've used up all my Elrond's Councils on both sides of the table. I think I have. Yep, all of them. Okay. So, 29 versus 8, and we reveal the front gate. And it's broad, which dragon will be able to attack against the first player. And Erebor bats. Okay, that's 8 threat added to the stage already. Now, this deck is questing with more characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if I exhaust Faramir, 35 versus 16. Now, I'm considering using Askeladd at the front gate. Yes, so let's completely heal up Glowing. And then use Askeladd to explore the front gate in the staging area. This removes 5 threat from the staging area and causes Swain to attack me. That will mean one less greeting on this side of the table. But I can still draw two Elrond's Council again. So yeah, spend spirit resource to move this over here, and discard shadow card. Glowin defends the attack. He has one defense, so he takes 7 damage. So now at this point I am making 24 progress, which is almost enough. So it's Dwarven Tomb, Elrond's Council. Alright, Dwarven Tombs, how many of those do I have left? Still one left for this deck, but don't think it's in the next 3 cards. And okay, so I don't think there's much point in me using Faramir Glowing and King of the Mountain sort of thing. But sure, why not? Let's draw from my cards. And okay. So, oh yes, that by the way, that's cancelled. It means I'm now making 25 progress. But first, Grosnavi's belt, naming Spirit. So I'm going to play Dwarven 2 to bring back a Gargoyle's Greeting. Actually, yeah, my greetings are also in this one. Oh. So, actually, for the greeting, yeah, let's put this deck down by 6. And then one more. For another Dwarven 2. And 3 more for another greeting. That's only the threat reduction I can do. And yeah, I make 25 progress. So 4 here. We'll be down to go to the victory display. Nope. Too far there. 21 progress on request, which is more than Smaug Magnificent's 20 hit points. So he is removed from play. And I have completed the quest stage, and therefore won the quest. So that actually worked out pretty much perfectly in the end. Just to mass up willpower, occasionally cancel awkward treacheries. Threat was the only problem, but obviously I have the means to deal with it. Burgle tests are actually pretty easy to deal with when you have tons of card draw. And yeah, just using the Riders of the Mark, of course, to avoid any problems with Chain Gun Smell. The inability to damage Smaug is not a problem at all, because you just get up to 21 progress. The one potential worry, I suppose, was that I could have... It's perhaps a bit surprising that I managed to get through perfectly without needing to go to stage 4. Though I think some of the effects that add more progress to Smaug the Golden may have been removed in the Shift to Nightmare. I'm not sure. I don't remember what all these cards do, so maybe not. Regardless, this worked out fine. On to Nightmare Battle 5 Armies. Thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Goodbye.